In front of me, I have all the components I need to build my custom 3D printed CNC. So today, we're gonna build it. Let's do this. Many of you may be wondering why I chose to build my very own CNC. And truthfully, there are three main reasons. First, being that I love CAD design and simply building engineering projects, I figured it would be a great challenge to promote growth in my knowledge of electromechanical assemblies while picking up skills and small tactics that are typically only learned through experience. Second, just as I got my new Artillery Sidewinder X1 3D printer, it opened new doors to larger 3D prints and therefore new projects due to its large build volume. Lastly, along with the potential to produce wooden products that I could eventually sell, I also wanted the ability to create custom parts out of wood, acrylic, polycarbonate, and even aluminum for future projects. As some of you know, 3D printing can be tremendously useful to create custom parts quickly. However, it has its limitations in strength, durability, and temperature resistance. Therefore, in order to progress at producing higher quality projects and prototypes, expanding my ability to create different custom parts out of other materials was a must. Being that this video is mainly going to demonstrate the assembly process of the machine and hopefully some cutting footage, most of the engineering and design work was done prior to this point. With that being said, about 8 hours of CAD design were put into designing the 20 plus 3D printed parts and also into dimensioning the stock parts that were purchased online in order to help me make a more accurate virtual model prior to assembly. These 3D printed parts were printed at 110 millimeters per second with 10 to 15% infill, which accumulated to be roughly 70 hours of print time. Along with this, with the machine being 42 by 42 by 15 inches in dimension, the machine carries a cutting area of roughly 3 feet squared. My desire for this large of cutting area was simply due to the idea that in the future I don't want to be hindered by my CNC in relation to the size of parts I can create. With some of the background information now out of the way, we can finally start the assembly, which is split up into three main sub-assemblies. These three sections include the left side of the Y-axis, the right side of the Y-axis, and the combined X and Z axis carriage. For the most part, all the prep work like cutting materials and sorting out the minor details have been taken care of to make the assembly more fluid. For the main assembly, the concept was similar to Lorenzo Battistino's, a fellow YouTuber, where the main frame is built using C-beam aluminum profiles. However, I did make several adjustments along with completely designing the machine from scratch on the Onshape CAD software. For the driving force, my CNC will be using 4 Nema 23 stepper motors, and it will be driven using 4 TB6600s and an Arduino Uno running GRBL. Lastly, for the machine cutter, the CNC will use a 500 watt spindle, which utilizes variable speed control. To start the assembly, we will begin with the left Y-axis, where we will use 1 1,000 millimeter C-beam profile and 2 3D printed end cap base mounts. To fasten these two together, we will use M4 socket head bolts that are threaded into T-nuts, which slide in and lock into the profiles. For the carriage on this linear rail, it uses a double-sided system with 12 V-wheels sandwiched in the middle. To put together this sub-assembly, there are 2 V-wheels separated by various 3D printed spacers and washers, which are all slid onto an M5 by 100 millimeter bolt. Alright, so now with the left Y-axis assembly completed, next we can move on to the right Y-axis assembly, which is simply the same section but mirrored on the other side, and it exchanges this NEMA 23 with this flange bearing. With both Y-axis assemblies finished, we can now go ahead and build the most complex section in the machine, which is the X and Z axis carriage. This section uses a 300mm profile along with 18 V-wheels, which seamlessly roll along the grooves in the vertical direction. Similarly to the Y-axis assemblies, the carriages use the same dimensions and use of 3D printed spacers and washers. Now with the three sub-assemblies finished, we can go ahead and bind them all together using M4 T-nuts and the last 1000mm profile. To connect all these elements, the base of the machine is a 4x4 MDF panel, which can be screwed in to the four base mounts using built-in spacers. As you can see, with the majority of the mechanical assembly complete, all three axes are rigid and smoothly glide along the profiles. But to add the final touches, I will now attach the cable chain mounts followed by the chains themselves. These will help with wiring in the future. Being that the CNC is mechanically finished, it is now time to move on to the electronics and the wiring of the machine. To do this, I will begin by soldering the stepper motor drivers and the spindle wires in order to increase their length, and then run them through the cable chains until they reach the control box. The control box will house things like the power supplies, the stepper motor drivers, the Arduino, and most of the project wiring. Finally, with the mechanical and electrical assembly complete, I just finished uploading GRBL to the Arduino, and now I can go ahead and power on the machine. As you can see, I can now control the motion of the machine using the jogging controls on CNCJS. And from my perspective, there aren't any unreliable points of motion in the machine, and therefore it is now time to see if this 3D printed CNC can actually reliably cut. Following the first successful test, that is all I have for this video, and so you should click right here to see my latest video. And if you'd like to join my project journey moving forward, I would invite you to subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon.